I hope you guys are doing well. So today we'll be creating this procedural rainbow shader. Okay, so it's actually going to be pretty simple, not anything advanced or anything. So let's get started. First thing you need to do is create these clouds. So the clouds I used created, they just have a simple emission material with value 1, and you also need to turn on the bloom. Okay, that's just it. And to create the clouds, you need to go Shift A, meta ball, ball. Let me just show you this. Meta balls are basically different than separate mesh. They automatically start linking with each other. So I have this meta ball above over here. When I shift it, duplicate it, as you can see, it's automatically linking with the other one. Okay, and if I shift it, this one, it's automatically linking with the other two. So you can actually duplicate and make these clouds easily yourself. It's not anything difficult. But remember, deleting these is sort of difficult, because if I deleted them from over here, you can see they automatically get all selected. For some reason, I don't know, it's a bug or anything. So if you're going to delete any of them, start deleting them from the side menu over here, just to be safe. So create the two clouds and add the cameras, and make the camera place in such a way that the two cameras are, the two clouds are like this, so that we can create the rainbow in between them like this. Okay, so I'll just take this third collection and I'll just hide the clouds for now. So we'll just go Shift A, mesh plane, RX90, and Control A to apply all transformations. Tap to go into edit mode, and we're going to delete three of these vertices and just going to keep this one. Okay, you can keep any one of them, but you know, so delete these vertices, and then A to select this vertice, and then G to move it about over here in the center. I'll just turn off proportional editing for now, and now we'll just turn on the clouds back on over here, and we're still in edit mode. Okay, so I'll just click on zero to go into camera view and extrude it like this over here on the top, and then extrude it over here on the other cloud, and then A to select all of it. Okay, and right click to subdivide. Then we have these two points, and then shift left both of these two points, and then start scaling it like this, and then add in a subdivision surface modifier on it about three levels. So when I tap out of right mode, you can see that this is going to be shaped. So now apply it, and then click on object while having this planes. Let's just call this a curve, because we're going to make it a curve. So define this curve, click on object, convert to curve from mesh text. So now this is a curve. Okay, I'll just hide the clouds again, and now again Shift A, mesh plane, RX90, tap to go into edit mode, SX, and then start scaling it on the x-axis about this one, and then click on Control R and start adding multiple loop cuts. Okay, and then enter the mouse button, and then click over here to interact, and then to make this loop cuts final, and then A to select all of them, and then GX to move on the side, so that this last point is at the origin of okay, like this. You have to come out of edit mode while having this plane selected, click on it, and then add in a curve modifier. So select the curve that we have created before. I think we need to increase the size of the plane, so come out, and then SX again, GX to move it again on this side. You're going to have to take a couple of tries to make it properly like this. So now that we have the created, let's just name it Rainbow Mesh, and then click on Control A. This is an important point, all transformations. So now all transformations have been applied. This is important, because or else the material will not work properly. So now we're just going to give it a new material. I'll just call it Rain 3. Okay, and it's going to be basically an emission material, and the blend mode for this should be alpha blend, and the shadow mode should be none, because usually rainbows don't have shadows or anything. So the blend mode is alpha blend, because you know we're going to be doing some other stuff with it. So let's go into shading mode. Okay, let me just place it properly over here, and I don't know if I told you before, but turn on bloom, and these are the blend modes. So let's get started. So we need a mix shader, Shift A, mix shader, place it between them, turn the strength of the emission shader by 5, add in a transparent shader, Shift A, transparent, not the translucent, transparent shader, and then add it over here, add in a color ramp, plug the color into the factor, Shift A, separate, XYZ, Shift A, map node, and then Shift A, texture coordinate. So connect the object into the vector into the vector of the separate xyz, and the x of the separate xyz into the color m. And we also need in to add in a empty. So let's just add a shift a empty plane axis, and we'll just call this one a controller. Okay, so this is going to control our rainbow moving from over here to over here. So go back into the shading tab, click on this mesh over here, and now select the controller over here. So now we have the controller selected. So now we're still not done, because we have obviously have to give it colors. So select this setup over here, and then shift to duplicate it, put it down, remove the controller from this bottom setup, and change it to generated. From x to instead of x, make the z plugin over here, and then plug in the color into the emission. Okay, so now we need to add in a lot of colors. So click on constant, change the linear to constant from the bottom one. Okay, for the bottom one, not the top one. And you need to add in 7 colors to make this work properly. Okay, so all of them have to have a proper distance of a 0 point something. I think, I don't remember, I think 0.14 was it. So add, keep on adding more of these. By so it's 0.28 this time. So keep on adding different colors. Let's just add this color into this maroonish color for now. I'm not doing the colors properly right now, because again, if I start doing that, it will take some time. You can just look up a reference on Google or something to check the colors out. So 0.28 to 0. I think 2.8 to 4, I think, for something like that. Basically 0.14 should be a difference between all of them. Okay, so 0.14, 0.14, or you can see it for yourself. I just change the color to yellow or something. So just 7 colors. Okay, I'm just firstly putting in colors. If it looks ugly, I'm sorry, but time is of the essence. So let's just keep adding more colors. And I think these are 7 colors. Yes, so now just in a purple one. So now these are 7 colors. Now let's go back off out of the layout, and then I'm just going to go into material preview. Okay, and the curve. Now we need to duplicate this curve, so shift D to duplicate this curve, and then rename the curve as duplicate one, curve D, or something like that, so that you can identify them. You have to go into the edit mode of the duplicated curve, select this bottom part of it, and then EX to move it on the side. And then select this bottom part, EZ to move it downward, and then EX to move it on the side. We just need to do this part, you'll see a while later on. So select the controller, the empty. Okay, and we're going to add in a constraint on it. Add a constraint, follow path, and select the D curve path. Okay, so D curve path, and then animate path. So the controller automatically as this at this point. So right now, I'm just going to play to show you the preview. It's not the finalized preview. Okay, so let's just play it. As you can see, there's still some problems with this. So the reason for this one, let me just select the this one over here, control A, apply all transformations again, and you can see now it's starting to work again. Okay, I don't know why it does that, but you need to apply the all transformations again for it to work like this properly. But right now we're still not done, because again, as you can see, the rainbow isn't properly over here. So let's just go into the starting of the animation frame one with the controller selected, controller empty selected, go into its object properties. Okay, and we're going to be adding keyframes to this its rotation. Okay, only rotation. So on the frame one, click on I to add a keyframe. Let's play the animation. So about at this point, we can realize that the animation isn't proper. So R to rotate it like this, so that it looks properly over here. And then go into its rotation and click on I again. Then move it forward. And at this point again, we realize that it's not proper. Then rotate it again, and click on and take add a keyframe over here again. Then play it again. Again, there's the problem, and then we rotate it again like this, and then I again to add in a keyframes, play it again, and then again we see a problem over here, and then art like this, and I again, then play it again, and I think at this point we don't need to add more keyframes. So let's just search in render view. The sky color is sort of like this simple hex color, sky blue color, I don't know. Just make the clouds reappear again. So let's just make the camera like this. And let's just see this one more time finally. So as to how to render it, there's going to be a link to how to render an animation in the description. So kindly check that out. And I hope you guys like this video. Please leave a like, comment, and subscribe to our channel. I'll see you next time in the next tutorial. Goodbye.